Today's spoiler video is brought to you by Card Kingdom. Use the link below to pre-order your cards today. Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another daily dose of Modern Horizon spoilers. And I think today it's kind of combo day. We got some sweet commander cards, we have some non-combo cards, some lower rarity stuff, but really, we got a lot of cards that can be part of sweet combos in Modern and Commander, wherever you want to play them. So, combo day here in spoiler land, and we better jump right into it. Start talking about these sweet cards and combos. Before we do, a super quick reminder. If you haven't already, it would be amazing of you if you could take a second, click that subscribe button down at the bottom of your screen. It's a great way to support the channel and the site for free. So let's talk some Modern Horizons, starting with a new artifact, Scrapyard Recombiner, and this card's pretty interesting. So, 3 mana, you get a 0/0, but it has modular 2, so it comes into play with 2 counters. When it dies, you move those counters to another artifact creature, and then you can sack an artifact to tutor your library for a construct card and put it in your hand. So, this is a card that has a couple of pretty easy homes in Modern right off the bat. So, most obviously, something like Hardened Scales, or even maybe Affinity. Hardened Scales is more likely, but those are decks that are care about artifacts and naturally tend to play a bunch of constructs. So Hardened Scales in specific, Scrapyard Recombiner can snag you by sacking a random artifact that you already kind of don't mind dying because a lot of them trigger when they die or whatever, but it can snag you like a Hangerback Walker, it can snag you a Walking Ballista, it can snag you a Steel Overseer, and those are a lot of the main engine pieces of the Hardened Scales deck. So we'll see. I mean, it is 3 mana, it does kind of need to untap and be unsummoning sick, but it seems really powerful to like play a Hangerback Walker, put some counters on it with Hardened Scales, sack it to Recombiner to grab another Hangerback Walker, Walking Ballista, a Steel Overseer, whatever you need. So it seems like an easy engine piece for that deck. Also has some other weird potential, not as obvious as far as top tier Modern homes, but there's some other good constructs. Like you can grab K'Thoth the Forge Master. We've seen people messing around with like give Forge Master haste, sack artifacts, tutor up Blightsteel or whatever type decks. Scrapyard Recombiner could be a way to find your Forge Master there, and worst case, you can sack it to the Forge Master. Scrap Trawler, an engine of graveyard artifact combo decks, is also a construct, so an additional copy of that where you can sack it, and again, Scrap Trawler decks kind of want artifacts going to the graveyard, so being able to sack an artifact, get a Scrap Trawler, and then when your next artifact goes to the graveyard, get back the first artifact you sack to start the Scrap Trawler loop seems pretty sweet as well. And all the Gearhulks are also constructs, and they're not top tier Modern cards, but Torrential Gearhulk has shown up. I could see like Verdurous Gearhulk, maybe that's a one of in the top end of like Hardened Scales or something. That's a lot of counters if you play a Verdurous Gearhulk, so I think Scrapyard Recombiner is actually really powerful. It's a little annoying that it misses out on hitting Arcbound Ravager, but really, seems like it could be at least tried in the Hardened Scales deck, and there's some other sweet potential landing spots as well. Next on our list, we have one of the spiciest new commanders we've seen in a long time, Sisay, Weatherlight Captain. So 3 mana, you get a 2/2, but it grows +1/+1 for each other color among legendary permanents you control. And then, this is the crazy part, pay a mana of each color, tutor your library for a legendary permanent with converted mana cost less than Sisay's power, put it on the battlefield, directly on the battlefield, and then shuffle your library. So almost like a repeatable Bring to Light on a legendary potential commander. So obviously, this is a callback to the original Captain Sisay, which was able to just tap and tutor for a legend. However, it only went to your hand. So yes, you get to activate it for free, but then you gotta spend mana to cast the card. Sisay, you have to spend more up front to activate it, but you're getting that card directly on the battlefield uncounterably. So what do you do with Sisay, primarily in Commander? I mean, maybe it could show up in Modern, seems less likely, but really, in Commander, it seems super sweet. So first off, when it comes into play, you can tutor up things that basically cost 2 or less, even if you have no other legends, which means you can snag like Gaia's Cradle, any of the legendary lands, and while paying 5 mana for a land might not sound that great, if that land is like Gaia's Cradle, it's probably netting you that mana back. You can snag creatures like Gaddock Teague. Once you get Sisay more powerful, you can grab like Teferi, any planeswalker you want, any legendary permanent at all, artifacts, enchantments, lands, planeswalkers, creatures, so there's a ton of options that you can snag with Sisay. The other thing you can do is play this in a 5-color deck, and I think while Sisay is a cool commander, it could also show up in the 99 of a deck like Child of Lara, Nimbus at Reborn, Chroma, any 5-color deck, because if you have out a 5-color legend like Nimbus at Reborn, your Sisay is automatically going to get +5/+5, so it's going to be a 7/7 for 3, and then you pay 5 to tutor up any legend, convert a mana cost 7 or less, which is really powerful. So while being the commander is probably the most common home for Sisay, a great member of the 99 for 5-color decks as well, with an ample number of legends. Plus, you can do some cool tricks, like Blackblade Reforge, awesome with Sisay. You tutor it up right away, put it on Sisay Weatherlight Captain, and then all of a sudden, Sisay is going to be huge, and you're going to be tutoring out massive things. You get to the point where you're tutoring out Eldrazi if you want to with Sisay, so really powerful there. Hammer of Nezahan is another sweet one. Costs a little bit more, 4 mana, so you got to have a couple of legends or a power boost for Sisay, but then it comes into play and makes Sisay indestructible, and it gives it +2 power, so you can tutor out bigger things. The other thing you could do, and this is like the Tomer plan, is use Sisay to put together Cauldra, and I expect you'll be seeing this on a Commander Clash soon. If you know Tomer, Tomer loves trying to assemble Cauldra. It's like one of his favorite things in the world. So I wouldn't be surprised to see a Sisay Cauldra deck where if you can make some mana, you're able to just tutor up all the pieces, get Cauldra. Cauldra is not that good, as we've learned in past Commander Clashes, but still, Shield of Cauldra protects Sisay, then you pump it, then eventually you make a 4-4. The other really sweet thing about Sisay, and this is probably my favorite part of the card, is if you can make infinite mana. Let's say you have some mana rocks, Isochron Scepter, Dramatic Reversal, or a combo like Palancron with Deadeye Navigator to keep untapping your lands, you could just tutor every legend from your deck onto the battlefield. I mean, yes, Sisay's power has to be cheap enough, but you can work around that. I'm sure there's ways to boost the power of Sisay where you're going to be fine to just tutor everything, but infinite mana, just tutor every legend out of your deck, seems like a really cool thing to do with Sisay. So I think that Sisay, Weatherlight Captain, going to be a really popular commander. It's cheap enough to come down, you can recast it multiple times, and then in the late game when you have a lot of mana, it is a really powerful way to tutor up whatever you need. And unlike the original Captain Sisay, it's in 5 colors. You don't have to just play green and white legends, you can play any legends you want. So this seems like a really powerful, really fun commander coming in Modern Horizons. Next up, we have Arula's Influence, and this is basically Bear Assault. It's essentially a Seismic Assault, literally a Greed Seismic Assault, except instead of discarding a land to deal 2 damage, you discard it to make it 2-2 Bear, which makes it also a little bit like Zombie Infestation. So I think Arula's Influence is kind of interesting for certain decks. So first off, it's great for like Gitrog Monster. If you get down a Gitrog Monster, you discard a land, you draw a card, maybe you have Life from the Loam to grind it out. You even go infinite with Dakmore Salvage and Gitrog Monster. You just like discard Dakmore Salvage, which triggers Gitrog Monster to draw a card, so you dredge Dakmore Salvage back to your hand, then you discard it again to make a bear, and then you dredge it again. So you can go through essentially your entire deck, make like 20 bears or something, could even potentially try to win with like Lab Maniac or New Jace after you empty your library. So that's an easy infinite combo there. Plus, you can just go on the Life from the Loam grind plan, where you just like discard 3 lands, make some bears, get them back with Life from the Loam, discard some more lands, make some more bears. The other fun thing you can do with Arula's Influence, and I'm not sure this is better than the other options, but we've played like the Treasure Hunt deck in the past, the Zombie Hunt, where you cast Treasure Hunt in a deck that's essentially all lands, use Reliquary Tower so you don't have to discard a hand size. You can Treasure Hunt into Arula's Influence, discard all your lands, make a bunch of bears. Is this better than the other options like Zombie Infestation or even Seismic Assault? I don't really know. I think I like Arula's Influence better as like the grind plan or the Gitrog Monster plan, but if you want a spicy way to go on the Treasure Hunt plan, Arula's Influence definitely can get the job done and make a ton of bears to let you win the game. So really cool callback to an old card in Seismic Assault, and maybe even some playability as well. Next up, we have a rare reprint, and this is one of those combo cards. We've already been talking about combos. Infinite mana with Sisay, going crazy and going infinite with Gitrog Monster with Arula's Assault. Well, Altered Dimension Adventure is a card that you almost never play fairly. 2-mana artifact, sack a creature, target player mills a number of cards equal to the creature's power. So Altered Dementia is essentially a piece for infinite mill combos. And we're going to talk about some of the easiest infinite mill combos. I did want to mention, though, there might be potential to use this on yourself. If you're playing a graveyard-based deck, remember it does say target player. So you can, like, sack all your blood gas to mill yourself for maybe up to 8 or your Gravecrawlers, maybe mill some Venge Vines, play a land, get back your blood gas, kind of grind out value from your graveyard that way. But that's the fair way to play Altar of Dementia. Normally, how you're going to see people play Altar of Dementia is an infinite mill combo. So, number one, you can go infinite mill with something like Malaira or Anafenza with a Kitchen Finks or any persist creature. The Malaira or Anafenza basically counteract the -1/-1 counter from the Kitchen Finks. So you just sack Kitchen Finks, it comes back into play, sack Kitchen Finks, it comes back into play, mill your opponent for 3 every time until they're completely out of cards and you win the game by milling them out. So that's one easy way to do it. You can also use other persist creatures like Woodfall Primus, lets you blow up all your opponent's lands, which is pretty spicy. Murderous Redcap, infinite damage along with infinite mill. But really, the infinite mill part wins the game most of the time anyway. You can also do some janky fun things with like Sun Titan. Sun Titan with Kaya's Ghost Form or Gift of Immortality, you're able to sacrifice the Sun Titan, which is going to put the Sun Titan and the Kaya's Ghost Form or Gift of Immortality into the graveyard, but then the Gift of Immortality or Kaya's Ghost Form is going to return the Sun Titan, which then can get back the Ghost Form or Gift of Immortality on the Sun Titan, so you sack it again, then you get back the Sun Titan with Ghost Form or Immortality, put it on the Sun Titan again and again and again, mill for 6 every time until your opponent is completely out of cards. So Altar of Dementia, I don't know if it'll be a top tier deck, but it is a spicy card. It allows for some really sweet infinite mill combos that just didn't exist in Modern before. So I'm really excited to build at least like a sweet against the odds deck with like the Sun Titan combo or maybe the Persist combo, with Altar of Dementia being the centerpiece in the win condition for the deck. Speaking of sweet commanders, we probably have the best grizzly bear of all time, Aryula, Queen Among the Bears. So it's a literal grizzly bear, it's legendary, a 2-mana 2/2, but when another bear enters the battlefield, you get to choose to either put 2 counters on it, so you make your grizzly bear into a 4/4, or target bear you control gets to fight a creature you don't control. So this card, I mean, I don't know if it'll actually do anything everywhere. Actually, I'm pretty convinced it won't. We're a long way from Grizzly Bear being a playable Modern card or even a playable Standard card. However, it is really sweet. So obviously, a callback to Grizzly Bears itself, the initial bear of Magic. However, this card fills an important role, which is it is a bear commander. We do have Goreclaw, and Goreclaw is fine, but Goreclaw actually isn't a great bear commander because Goreclaw cares about big creatures with power 4 or greater, and bears are traditionally 2/2, so Aryula is basically the bear commander that we've always wanted. It is a grizzly bear, it is legendary, it has bear focus upsides, so we have some bears that are good. Grizzly Fae, Aryula's Influence, I guess Goreclaw is fine. I don't think that this will be a very competitive commander deck, but it's definitely a sweet and flavorful card, and as we get more bears, slowly gets better, maybe we'll actually be a real commander deck eventually, but for now, if you want to make a ton of bear puns and have a semi-competitive commander deck, Aryula is definitely the way to go as your commander. We also got some other interesting lore rarity stuff. Generous Gift, basically a white version of Beast Within, probably going to be good in Commander. I don't know if it'll show up in Modern, but it can destroy a land, and sometimes Beast Within shows up as land destruction in Modern. Umezawa's Charm, not really that powerful outside of Limited. Get to give a creature -1/-1, or +2/+2, or gain 2 life, but it's a cool callback to Umezawa's Jitte, which is basically a one-shot activation of it in Charm form. And then we got Splicer's Skill, which is kind of a callback to an old mechanic, the splice onto arcane mechanic, except Splicer Skill, you can splice onto any instant or sorcery. So basically, you can cast it as a sorcery to make a 3/3 for 3, which, that's fine, especially in Limited. Or let's say you cast a Serum Visions, you can pay 4, and you basically just attach Splicer Skill to it and give your Serum Visions a kicker of a 3/3 golem, and the Splicer Skill stays in your hand. So then you can, let's say, cast another spell and opt in the future. then you splice it onto it. If you cast an instant, you can splice onto it at instant speed and make a surprise chump blocker. So a really fun, cool card, although probably not powerful enough or fast enough for our current modern format. And then Changeling Outcast is another sweet callback. It's basically a Tormented Souls, except in shapeshifter form. Maybe could show up in like a ninja deck. A 1/1 unblockable ninja for one is actually kind of relevant if you're trying to put Ninja of the Deep Hours or Yukihiro and cards like that into play with ninjutsu. So kind of a fun common and another sweet callback to a, well, I don't want to say iconic, but a card from Magic's past. Ravenous Giant, not going to show up in Modern, but it's a cool callback to Zhuzhumjin, which is a really iconic older card. Back in the old days of Magic, the earliest days, a 4-mana 5/5 that did 1 damage to you was like the biggest, baddest, most powerful creature in Magic. Well, now Ravenous Giant, it's the same thing in red, and maybe it's okay in Limited. Like, that's how far we've come in terms of creatures, where the literal best creature in Magic, or one of them from the early days, is kind of just a meh uncommon, but a cool flavor callback. We also got a ton of interesting lower rarity stuff that probably mostly going to be fine for Limited. Frostwust Bastion, Glacial Revelation, good if you got a lot of snow permanents. Thundering Djinn can be sweet if you can draw a bunch of cards, maybe a wheel decking commander, it can deal a ton of damage. Zelfred's Decoy, mostly a aggressive tapper for Limited. Good Fortune Unicorn, if you play a lot of creatures, you get a lot of counters, maybe proliferate them. Etchings of the Chosen, a unique anthem for certain tribal decks. Anyway, that has been our daily dose of Modern Horizon spoilers for today. So what do you think of all these new cards? How good is Scrapyard Recombiner? Is that going to show up in Harnscale's Affinity? Can it show up in other decks? How busted is Sisay as a commander? What about Aryula and Aryula's influence? Are those cards just kind of fun commander cards? Can influence actually show up in Modern? We get Trogmonts, or is it just a commander thing? How about Altar of Dementia? What other combos are there to infinitely mill your opponent out of the game all in one turn? All the lower rarity stuff, what do you think about that? Can Generous Gift show up outside of Commander? What about Umezawa's Charm? The new splice mechanic? Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will talk to you soon. Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.